Hi guys, so I'm back today with a quick video, well, quickish. This is a project share. This is for a swap that I joined over on Facebook in a group called Loaded Envelopes Galore, and it was for one of their monthly swaps, and it was a, as you can see, a Wonder Woman theme swap. So I joined, and my wonderful partner's name is Monique, and I will, I don't have her, YouTube channel, but I will, I do have a link for some of the work that she's done before. Anyway, so I will obviously link that below. So there were some requirements for the swap. It had to be a mini one, and using, Tamika, Scrap the World's, tutorial was one that they incurred, so I used that. So it's about a 4x6 envelope. Let's see what else. It has to be at least two pockets, and mine has two pockets. Have to have at least an envelope, one envelope with tag, stickers, and anything that you want, just like little items. And then a jumbo tag, one altered paper clip, one wand, at least five embellishments, and at least two Wonder Woman inspired images, and then five die cuts packaged nicely as well. And I think that's it. So those were the requirements, and then obviously you can do anything above and beyond that. So the traditional Wonder Woman theme is, you know, the red and the blue and yellow, the very traditional kind of patriotic colors. And then the new Wonder Woman colors that have come out are more of the blacks and the golds and stuff like that. So I actually was thinking about this swap, and I was like, oh my gosh, how awesome would it be to do a like a shabby chic, or, you know, something a little more feminine. So one of my friends, Jacqueline, she found some printable paper from a seller on Etsy, and she is, it's called the Gemmed Snail, and I will remember to link her down below. So I saw her paper and I was like, that is such cute paper. And then I was thinking, I wonder if she'll do a special order. So I contacted her, and she was so awesome and so fast. She changed the colors of the paper that she had, the printable. So this was kind of a special order paper. And I'll show you guys the envelope in just a little bit. But I'll start kind of taking everything out so I can show you the envelope by itself. So in this first pocket, let's go ahead and start. I don't even know where to start, so I'm not going to hurt anything. So in this first is an envelope, and it's die cuts. It's a vellum envelope that I made, and I just embossed it. It's just some kind of iridescent vellum, and I had one of these metal, it's not metal, but I got it from Hobby Lobby, and I did a few Wonder Woman cuts, just the emblem, and I did two in pink, and then two in a lighter blue with gold, and then the shimmer paper. And then in there I did some cuts. Oopsies. I did, here, I'll show you. So I did some word die cuts in the same glitter paper and the foil, and I left this insert, so, and I actually put some washi behind it so the eye doesn't get lost, but that is cut out. I just didn't want the eye to get lost, so I did those words. And then I did some miniature of the Wonder Woman emblems, and again I did two pink and two blue of those. And then I did two just Wonder Woman, just then her name, and then obviously one in pink, one in blue. And I had a bunch of leftover paper, so I made some pinwheels, and I had printed the paper front and back, so there I just cut out a bunch of those. And then I have some Wonder Woman inspired photos, and these four Excuse me. These four are the original ones that I found. And then these three were ones that I altered the color. I just made them lighter, so they're the more pastel. So those are some things that I did. This is just a little pinwheel with another one on a gold paper clip with another one of the Wonder Woman emblems. Excuse me. A little altered clothespin. And this is a die from Little Yellow Bicycle. Or wait. Is that the Little Yellow Bicycle? It's over here. It's Little Bee Designs. And it's from this. And it comes with two different bows and then a box. But I love this little bow. And I just cut it out of foil paper and added it to a sparkly Recollections clothespin. And then a flower from my stash. And go ahead. This is just some, what are they, planner stickers, like planner flags. And I just took a piece of the gold cardstock and wrapped it around like that. And then I just added a Wonder Woman emblem there. And I thought of her cuffs, you know, like her wrist cuffs. That was kind of the idea behind that. This is a little altered notebook. And I found this glitter my brain just left, this glitter letter and pearls, and her name is Monique, so the M, and then a little gold pen. Now, I found this little pen from, I think it's a Heidi Swap pen. I took it out of the packaging, but it is, I got it at Hobby Lobby, added a little gold tassel, a little paper clip, and I added some of the little sweetheart flowers there. And up here I added a miniature sweetheart flower just to cover up where the tassel actually sits. So I did that. This is some spare parts, and I just did a topper with another gold bow. The what is this one? EK Success Punch. And they're just little gold charm letters. This is, again, just another topper and two little stamps. So this one, what one is this one? I don't even remember. But this is a Heidi Swap one. And then this one, I think, is from Michael's. Yeah, this one was from Michael's Just the Dollar Spot. And it's a planner one. I don't know if she's really into planners that much, but I thought, you know, they're pretty big right now. And then these are three die cuts. So this one says smile, this one says hello, and this one says happy. So there's three packs in there. And again, this is just kind of a belly band with the gold bow on it. And then I have two altered pencils, and there's just some more pinwheels. And I hot glued them to there so she could take them off. But I just added a little gold star in the center. And then to cover up the hole, I added a pearl. Okay. And then this is the first wand. And I took one of, it's just one of the Michael straws. There's another Wonder Woman icon on the back. But I just took one of the images, this one actually, and I circle punched it, and it cut off part of, you know, Fight Like a Woman. So I just added some flowers down at the bottom, a tiny little star right there in her crown. You guys can see that. And just flowers all the way around the outside. And if you guys look at this, this is, it's a cut from my silhouette, and it's cutting little stars in there. So I thought that was really cute. And then this is another altered paper clip. It's just another rosette, and then the Wonder Woman emblem right there on the front. And it's just plain on the back. So in the other pocket, there's another altered paper clip with another emblem. And it's just another little pinwheel. And then this is spare parts. And again, it's just another gold belly band with the gold bow. And it's just two words, like metal words. And they're meant to look like the paper clip, but they're much sturdier than that. Another little altered clothespin, and this is just a pink version of it, so it's exactly the same as the blue one. Another couple altered pencils, just pencils that I added the pinwheels to. And then this is just another little photo topper, and it's got just gems in it, or gems, pearls. So there's a pack of white and pink, and then there's the blue pearls. And I actually think I put the bow on the wrong side, but that's okay, whatever, right? It's still a cute little idea. This is just another little belly band. And again, this one, it just reminded me of Wonder Woman's cuffs, and it's spare parts, and it's just, these are really heavy, but it's got silver, gold, and that copper or rose gold diamonds. And those are just some fun embellishments. Oopsies. This is just another altered clothespin, so it's just the pink version of the blue. Going through, I did try and do one pink, one blue. This is just a little pack of dies, and it just says hi, hello, and thanks, little exclamation point. And I just found that at Hobby Lobby. Another little wand. And so again, this is just another image that I cut out, created the rosette. And I actually inked these in gold color box ink and just added some flowers. And then there's some pearl spray, or not pearl sprays, but pearl trim right there. And then on the back is just another Wonder Woman emblem. And then just some ribbon and some lace right there. And then the last thing in there is actually my tag. And so my tag is just one of those Tim Holtz tags, and I added some pattern paper to the front and back, a pearl trim, and then some flowers from my stash. And then this is a cut from my silhouette. And what I did was I cut her out in the gold foil paper and then just added some of the miniature sweetheart blooms throughout like that. Let me see if take it out of there. I just put it in there to protect it. Added some trims and some laces to the top, and then I added a little blue cherry blossom to the top to keep keep the trims and laces in place. I added some of the gold stars and then just the pearls in the centers to cover up the little holes. On my silhouette, I cut from pink glitter paper and then the gold foil, the Wonder Woman name, and then just added some flowers from my stash, and then another one of those metal Wonder Woman emblems. And on the back side is just plain. It is just the Wonder Woman paper and more pearls. I just kept the back side. I didn't add anything to the back. But I put it in this little bag because as things go in and out, I didn't want something to catch on it and, you know, rip something off of the tag. So I just added, just put it in a bit in one of my card bags, and then added just a little bit of washi right there. Okay, and then this is the actual envelope. Okay, so what I did was, this is the paper from the gemmed snail, and so I printed it out, and first I printed it out on just cardstock, and it was okay, but the color was kind of not as good. So I was like, well, let me try it on photo paper. And the photo paper really made the big difference. Not only is it glossy, but the gold parts look a little more gold, and it's just really fun. So this is the back side of it, and it's just the printed paper, and sorry about the glare, but as you can see, it's kind of the Wonder Woman costume. So there's the gold and pink and the stars. And then on the front, there's a large emblem. I use some lace trim from my stash. This is just some pearl trim as well. And then this, just more, it's almost like a Chinese braid, but not quite. And then to hide the back, I actually put pearls along the bottom because sometimes the glue will seep out. So I just put the pearls to kind of just finish it off. Along the front, I just added more and then just a bunch of flowers from my stash. And the majority of these are Wild Orchid Crafts. I don't think any of them are I Am Roses at this point. Nope, I think they're all Wild Orchid Crafts. Another one of the metal Wonder Woman emblems. And then this is a printout that I found online, and I fussy cut her, and then I also added glossy accents to her to make her super shiny and just a little more dimension. And she wasn't quite, I'm kind of bummed about this. I mean, it's still cute, but she wasn't so gray when I first did it, but as soon as I put the glossy over it, she just turned kind of gray. But I think it's still cute, and it still kind of goes with everything. So that is my loaded envelope. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!